Hi, I'm Mr. Beat, one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we'll combine the concepts of consumer budget constraints and consumer indifference curves to illustrate how consumers optimize their budget to achieve their highest utility. When a combination of goods is on the budget constraint line, and the trade-offs along a consumer's indifference curve are equal to the trade-offs along the budget constraint, this combination of goods maximizes consumer utility. Garrett consumes hours at the gym and hours online gaming with friends. He is also a busy student who can only afford 6 hours per week for these two activities. We can model his budget constraint of time with a simple graph. For example, if he currently spends 3 hours per week at the gym, he can only afford 3 hours per week gaming online. Garrett faces a one-for-one trade-off between gym hours and online hours. If he forgoes 1 hour of gym time, he gains 1 hour of online time. This slope value of -1 represents the marginal rate of substitution that is affordable along Garrett's budget constraint. We've examined Garrett's budget of affordable combinations of gym time and online time. Now let's look at his willingness to trade off one good for the other while retaining the same level of utility. Garrett's tastes and preferences for consuming these two goods can be expressed by an indifference curve, which indicates those combinations of goods that will produce the same level of utility. This is much like the contour line of a topographical map that describes the different combinations of latitude and longitude that remain on the same elevation of a mountain. If Garrett currently enjoys 3 hours of gym time and 3 hours of online time each week, this combination produces a utility level of 100 units. However, if he sacrifices 1 hour of gym time, he must be compensated by 2 hours of additional online time just to maintain that same level of utility. This slope value of -2 represents the marginal rate of substitution that maintains Garrett's utility level. The higher the quantity of online hours relative to gym hours, the more online hours that are needed to compensate Garrett for one lost gym hour and still retain the same utility. This arises because consumers generally experience diminishing marginal utility as they consume increasing quantities of any one good. In Garrett's case, the utility loss from one less gym hour is greater than the utility gained from only one additional online hour. Therefore, more online hours are required to maintain the same level of utility. How will we know that Garrett is allocating his time optimally? When he is consuming a combination of goods that is on his budget constraint and the slope of his budget constraint is equal to the slope of his indifference curve. Garrett is currently consuming the maximum budgeted hours each week with 3 hours each of gym time and online time. What if he were to consume more online time and less gym time? The affordable marginal rate of substitution along his budget constraint lets him substitute one additional hour of online time for one less hour at the gym. This trade-off occurs at a slope value of -1. However, the indifference curve reveals that Garrett would need to receive 2 additional hours of online time just to maintain the same level of utility. This trade-off occurs at a slope value of -2, which is shallower than the -1 slope value of the budget constraint. Therefore, exchanging additional affordable gym hours for fewer online hours would decrease Garrett's utility level. Consumers optimize their budget allocations when they consume a combination of goods that have two important characteristics. First, the combination of goods must be on the budget constraint. Second, the marginal rate of substitution along the budget constraint at that combination must be equal to the marginal rate of the substitution of the indifference curve. If you're still having trouble with consumer choice optimization, come visit us at Chegg, where you can see solutions that we've already worked out, or ask for help directly from one of the Chegg subject matter experts.